Well, today we are going to hand capture a brown bat that has gotten into the living space. You can see we've got vents here that run down to the basement, which we haven't checked out yet. We just want to grab this bat before he flies away. These are absolutely large enough vents for a bat to get into the living space, which we're going to look around, see if there's any other areas, maybe a ceiling fan or any other ductwork. Obviously, this house is being finished right now, so things are open. There's no caps. This is a large vent here. Very well could be an access point. Normally, we're seeing bats in the attic, not in a basement. But if the duck, you know, attaches to any of the wall voids or anywhere like that, you know, it could have gotten into the void, came down, got into a vent, came up here. So we can't confirm it yet, but we're going to at least hand capture this bat now, get him in a cage, release him. We don't ever want to kill bats. We just want to relocate them and seal the house up to make sure no new bats come inside. Usually they come in pairs, so we'll be surprised if we find another one in the attic or more. At this point, the young are able to fly on their own, so us grabbing this adult won't be a problem. The bats should be self-sufficient and ready to go, but we will double check to see if we see any young in the attic before we leave today. So we're gonna carefully grab this guy, and here we go. All right, gently. Surprise them. Sleeping. And here's your little brown bat. And yeah, kind of woke them up. Actually, that looks like that could be this year's. He's kind of small. So, all right, well, we got one. He might be able to squeeze through that. Hopefully not, but for now, it doesn't look like he's going anywhere. Maybe he's even a little dehydrated. I don't know how long he's been in this living space. So, all right, so now that we have our bat, we're gonna do the inspection of the rest of the house and see what's going on here.